Precepts of Evil by Clark Ashton Smith. Bow down. I am the Emperor of Dreams. I crown me with the million-colored sun of secret worlds, incredible, and take their trailing skies for vestment when I soar, throned on the mounting zenith and illume the space-ward flown horizons infinite. Like rampant monsters roaring for their glut, the fiery crested oceans rise and rise, by jealous moons maleficently urged to follow me forever. Mountains horned with peaks of sharpest adamant and marred with sulfur-lit volcanoes, lava lang, usurp the skies with thunder, but in vain, and continents of serpent-shapen trees with slimy trunks that lengthen league by league pursue my flight through ages spurned to fire by that supreme ascendance. Sorcerers and evil kings, predominantly armed with scrolls of fulvous dragon skin, whereon our worm-like runes of ever-twisting flame would stay me, and the sirens of the stars, with foam light songs from silver fragrance wrought, would lure me to their crystal reefs and moons, where viper-eyed, senescent devils dwell, with antic gnomes abominably wise, heave up their icy horns across my way. But...
That, isn't that wonderful? That is a reading of The Hashish-Eater by Clark Ashton Smith. Superbly read by Donald Sidney Fryer, who is himself a delightful poet, a phenomenal poet, and has been a poet, a sublime poet for many decades. And he actually knew Clark Ashton Smith. He has written exhaustively about Clark Ashton Smith. He edited, do I have it? Let me turn on my light. Oh, where is it? If I can find it. He edited for Arkham House the prose. Here we are. Turn off the bloody light. Prose and Poems by Clark Ashton Smith. Has a delightful jacket illustration by, I believe, Frank Luck Patel. I thought it was by Howard Wandry. And this, it's illustrated also. I need my glasses to see who illustrated it. Is it illustrated by Patel as well? Yes. With interior illustrations. I have forgotten that. S.T. Joshi has said that Clark Ashton Smith is perhaps the finest prose poet in the English language. Poems and Prose by Clark Ashton Smith. And with a lengthy introduction by, if I can find it, Donald Sidney Fryer. It's quite lengthy. But this, published by Hippocampus Press, is the entire The Hashish-Eater And it includes a CD-ROM, or an audio CD, of Donald Sidney Fryer reading the entire poem. Isn't that delightful? And, oh, what was that? Oh, that was the CD falling out. And there is, I might as well just leave my other glasses on. There's an introduction about the poem. I believe there are let's see. There's an introduction by Ron Hilger about Clark Asher Smith and the Hashish-Eater. And then there is commentary. The book is quite substantial for being so thin. It's very wee. And it's delightful. And it is, I believe it is still available from Hippocampus Press. Hippocampus Press, of course, I don't have them down here, downstairs. They published the complete poetry of Clark Ashton Smith in three amazing hardcover editions. I believe those three hardcover editions will soon be published in paperback. And but for those who cannot wait, Hippocampus Press has published The Last Oblivion, which is the best fantastic poems of Clark Ashton Smith, edited by S.T. Joshi and David E. Schultz. There's a wee picture of Smith. And this has a front cover illustration by Clark Ashton Smith. And then on the inside, color reproductions of artwork by Smith. Very good. I'm really diving into Clark Ashton Smith because the next book that I am going to write as soon as I return from MythosCon will be a collection of weird fiction poetry and poems in prose, all of which will be inspired by the fiction of Clark Ashton Smith. All of his fantasy fiction, so much of which appeared in the magazine Weird Tales, has been published in those five Hansen hardcover editions from Nightshade Books. But that is a wonderful reading of the Smith poetry by Donald Sidney Fryer. I love the way he rolls his R's, and it's delicious when he speaks in French. I was able to meet him once at last year at the World Fantasy Convention in San Jose, and I shall be meeting him next month when we gather in Phoenix, Arizona for MythosCon. I hope a lot of you are attending MythosCon. The first weekend of January, it begins January 6th, which is, I believe, a Thursday. And it will be an entire weekend, 4 days of H.P. Lovecraft and the Cthulhu Mythos. Go check out the website for MythosCon and just check out the members who are attending. It's astonishing. It is going to be the greatest gathering of Lovecraftians and Cthulhu Mythos fans of all time. I'm so excited. And there I will meet, for the second time, the delightful Donald Sidney Fryer. Another book published by Hippocampus Press is Donald Sidney Fryer's poetry, The Atlantis Fragments. The Sidney Fryer. A beautiful, beautiful book. Oh, I mean, look how thick it is. It's huge. How many pages is it? I shall need to put on my eyes again. Not in the mood to wear glasses, but I'm going to be 60 next year. I can't bloody believe it. 548 pages of poetry. My goodness. Just lots of poetry. By one of the finest weird poets. Writing in the genre, the fantasy genre. So I urge all of you, I urge all of you to check out the poetry of Clark Ashton Smith and Donald Sidney Fryer. I don't know if Donald's book is still available. It might have sold out. But I'm pretty certain that the wee poetry editions by Clark Ashton Smith are still available from Hippocampus Press. I'm really looking forward to this book. I am going to write it with dear Marianne K. Snyder, who has joined me here for some of my videos on Mr. Willem channel. So it's one of the very delightful things about YouTube for me, and this is this came as a surprise to me. There are many poets here, and there are many readings of poets. There's a channel devoted to animations of poets reading their verse. There's people reading. I just discovered today a wonderful young reader who reads Shakespeare, and he reads Shakespeare superbly. Oh my, just wonderful. And another delightful young fellow, anarchist and free thinker, Stone Golem 42 or Stone Golem 43. Now I cannot remember. I beg your pardon. It's my memory, you know. I'm old. I forget things. But he actually read a poem by Robert E. Howard, and he reads very well. He has that smooth southern accent, that soft southern accent, which is delectable. So after you watch my video, those of you who are watching, I urge you to seek out some poetry here on YouTube. And there's poetry readings of Baudelaire, Edgar A. Poe, of course, Oscar Wilde. YouTube is a wonderful font of literature. That came as a surprise to me. I figured it was just people being goofy and dressing up like morons for their webcam. But it is so much more. And that's what I've dedicated my channel to, is an investigation of literature here in this zone of electronic technology, which continues to astound me. The possibilities for communication and for sharing art and literature.